All right, everyone, welcome back to Cody's Lab. So James Dewar, when he was making liquid hydrogen, he used a bath of liquid oxygen as a coolant. Now this seems kind of strange because liquid hydrogen and liquid oxygen combine to make rocket fuel. Why would you put something so explosive together when you could use liquid nitrogen, which boils at an even lower temperature than oxygen, and perhaps get the hydrogen to go better? Well, there is one very important reason for this, which I hope to demonstrate today. So I have some liquid oxygen being produced. I'm just making it from the air today. Got an aquarium pump hooked up here and a Dewar flask full of liquid nitrogen. And then of course over here, I have some more liquid nitrogen. I'm gonna be putting that, both of those, into a vacuum chamber here in each of these little dishes. One will have oxygen, the other will have nitrogen. And you can see there's a couple little magnets in there holding it together. And if we have oxygen, then the oxygen should be magnetic. Okay, so first let's add the liquid nitrogen. That'll help cool things off. Okay. There's our nitrogen. And now I'm going to add the liquid oxygen. The oxygen has a bit of contamination, which includes CO2 and water that came from the air. See, if I bring another magnet over here, you should be able to see that indeed the oxygen is magnetic. Looks like I've buried the other magnet, but that's all right. So let me put the lid on the vacuum chamber now. And now I'm going to turn on the vacuum. It may be kind of loud, so headphone users, I want to turn down the volume. Okay, that wasn't too bad. So now as I suck out the air, the pressure will decrease, and that makes the liquids boil at a lower and lower temperature. Eventually, they'll be boiling at such a low temperature that they'll actually reach their triple point and freeze. Looks like the oxygen's boiling quite profusely here. The nitrogen seems to have stopped. And the nitrogen is frozen. And then it thawed out again all of a sudden. Tends to do that, doesn't it? Let's get a little bit better look over this. Looks like the pressure's down to negative 20 inches of mercury. I think 24 inches of mercury is the current barometric pressure. So there's the nitrogen freezing and turning into snow. That means the temperature that I've reached is now about 63 degrees Kelvin. And you'll notice the oxygen is still liquid. In fact, it's actually climbing onto the magnet a little bit more. Yes, very nice. Now I doubt that the oxygen will actually freeze until all of the nitrogen is frozen solid. Because, as you may have guessed already, oxygen has a lower freezing point than nitrogen does. It also has a higher boiling point, so oxygen has a wider liquid range. There was a metal pan next to the vacuum pump, that's why that was making so much noise. I can see the nitrogen's actually sublimating a little bit. See how it's like pulling away from the sides of the container? It's because there is still quite a lot of heat sources nearby. Yeah, I think the last of the oxygen just boiled away. Tell you what, let's actually do one of these rounds, but instead of having nitrogen next to it, let's just do pure oxygen. That way I don't have to wait for the nitrogen to boil off. That took over 10 minutes, and my vacuum pump is now overheated, so I need to let it cool off before I try again. So while I was waiting for the pump to cool and the oxygen to generate, I did a little bit of research online. You know, I looked at some phase diagrams and it looked like nitrogen's triple point was about 100 torr, or roughly 0.12-ish atmospheres, whereas oxygen's triple point is 1 torr, or about 1% of what nitrogen is. So of course, as long as I had nitrogen in the chamber, I wouldn't have any solid oxygen. That actually means that if you had liquid nitrogen on the surface of Mars, it would freeze solid, whereas oxygen would remain liquid. So I'm actually going to try to filter the oxygen this time so that I get some of that ice crystals out. Let's see how this works. You know what? I think that was mostly a success. Well, let's put this under vacuum and see if we can bring it down to one torr and not have any nitrogen to bother us. There we go. Now the pressure should drop even lower than last time because there's no nitrogen to sublimate away and build up the pressure. At least that's the idea. We're negative 23 inches of mercury and dropping. So I wouldn't expect the oxygen to freeze yet. Oh no, my vacuum pump just shut off. Too hot. So now that my vacuum pump's had a little bit of time to cool off, I'm going to do a couple of things different. This time I'm actually going to put the oxygen cup down inside of the Dewar flask with it already chilled to a very low temperature. So let's actually take this oxygen out. May as well pour it in here now. There we go. Now I'm going to take this and pour off the nitrogen. Now hopefully get this in there. And then put the oxygen down inside of it. Okay, that'll keep it colder. Let's put this over into the chamber. So the pressure is definitely lower than it was last time. We're very close to negative 24 inches. So that's practically zero atmosphere. But obviously, since the oxygen's still liquid, we're still above one torr. Something's happening in there. The oxygen seems to be kind of slushy at the moment. You can see it still kind of moves around, but it's definitely more viscous than it was before. You know what? I think I've got solid oxygen in there. Let me adjust this light a little bit. See when I move it, the oxygen doesn't slosh around. It's frozen. And the pressure is basically zero. Oh, this is awesome. There we go, that's a little better. So you can actually see that the oxygen is definitely crystallized. It seems the surface of it refuses to completely freeze. That's probably because of the heat that's coming in from the top. But look at that. We've got solid oxygen in there. That's 54 Kelvin. I think that's the coldest I've ever gotten. Let's turn the vacuum pump off and see if it melts again. Okay. Now I'm going to let in the atmosphere. It's definitely liquefied it. So how about that? I actually made solid oxygen and it's liquefied again. In order to get the hydrogen as cold as possible, he didn't have his cooling gases inside of an open container at one atmosphere. Instead, he put it under vacuum and pulled it down to the point where the gases nearly froze. If he would have used nitrogen, he would have had to lower the hydrogen's temperature by expanding it by another 40 Kelvin or to get to the 20 Kelvin needed to liquefy the hydrogen. By using oxygen, he only needed to lower it by about 30 Kelvin, which meant that he had to pressurize his hydrogen much less, which I suppose made it worth the risk of putting the hydrogen so close to the oxygen. I'm sure he still had explosions and stuff, but he was able to liquefy the hydrogen in the end. At some point, I hope to recreate this and liquefy hydrogen on my own. Of course, I've got a little bit better materials to use than Dewar did. Hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you next time.